y'all, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Kristen and I post a video every Monday. If not, welcome. Today we are talking about wedding registries and what to do with them after you already got married. So I already posted a video about a registry when you're about to get married, how to do it, where to go, and you guys can watch that after this video. I'll put it at the end. But this one is what to do with your registry once you've already got married. So I got my registry from Amazon and from Bed Bath & Beyond. I put those on my Not website, that way all of my guests were able to see that. And those two websites are really amazing because they email you alerts, they make it super easy to add things and delete things, and they have thank you lists as well, so at the end you can thank all of your guests for the gifts that they gave you, and so that's good to have there. But also at the end of your wedding, they'll send you an email or they'll send you something in the mail and it's a completion discount. And so Amazon and Bed Bath & Beyond both have 20% off your entire order or every single item on that order. And if you finish your registry with them, then you get that 20% off. So what we did is, with some of the money we got from our wedding, we went on Amazon because it's already the cheapest place to get most of the things we wanted. We went onto our Amazon registry, looked at the things that we absolutely needed for the house, and then the things that we didn't really need, we kept on our registry just in case we want to get it later. We have that right there. It's a good tool to go back on. But the ones that we really needed, we added it to our cart, put the completion discount in there, and got 20% off. So that's awesome. And then we waited a few months for Bed Bath & Beyond because those weren't really necessities. And just kind of once that we wanted, or we had two glassware things on there when we only got one, so we were waiting for the second set, something like that. And so we went into the store and got the 20% off of our entire order there as well. But when you get married and you get all your gifts from your registry, you kind of start putting them into your house and seeing where things make sense and seeing if you actually need those things. So I would definitely, number one, when you get married and you're going through your registry, just look through it, put all the stuff you already have in its place and see if those things on your registry are what you actually needed. And if they are, keep them there or buy them and then take the things off that aren't. Number two is, I did mine at Amazon, and that's pretty much the cheapest place that I can find. But Bed Bath & Beyond isn't really. So you can probably get the same item that was on my Bed Bath & Beyond registry at like Marshall's or Ross or Target and get it for cheaper or the same price. So that's something that I considered, and if there's a place I can get it somewhere else or something that looked like it. If you're getting dish towels, you don't really need to get those from Bed Bath & Beyond. You can just go to the dollar store or to Marshall's. You can get anything from Marshall's. So it's good to shop around now that you've already settled into your home and got all your gifts in there. Number three is, you can always go back into your registry. They don't cancel it. So you can always go back and look at the things that you wanted and get those later, or people can get them for you for Christmas or your birthdays, things like that. So registries are a really great tool to have before the wedding. That way all of your friends and family get to see all the gifts that you chose. But after the wedding, it's great to just review, take inventory of what you have in your home and what's actually needed, and see if you can get stuff that you would like better, because before the wedding, all you're thinking about is wedding, 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 and not really gifts. So you just click on the first thing you see. But afterwards, you have plenty of time on your hands, or at least I did. And so I can go to stores and just look around and see what I want instead of having to pick one thing from one store. So those are my tips on what to do with your registry after you get married. If you already got married and you finished your registries and you have some tips, go ahead and put those down in the comments below. And I will see you guys next Monday.